Do you want to know how to make a hyperlapse with the DJI Mavic Air 2? In this video, I'm going to show you how to access the hyperlapse feature, what types of camera settings there are, 8K, 4K, 1080p, RAW, JPEG, and also what different types of hyperlapses you can do with the Mavic Air 2. I did a rhyme. What's going on, guys? My name is Dan. If you're new here, I do drone how-to videos, video editing tutorials, and epic drone videos. Well, at least I think they're epic. If that's the type of content you're into, consider subscribing to the channel by clicking the little button down below. And if you really like what I'm doing, click the little bell icon right next to it, because every time I upload a new video, YouTube will be like, hey, Dan made a new video. Go click it. Thanks for the support. And for now, let's talk about hyperlapses. So before we get into the how of making a hyperlapse, I quickly want to talk about why you would even want to do a hyperlapse. A hyperlapse is basically a time lapse where not just your subject is moving, like the sun or the clouds, but also your camera. It creates a really cool dynamic effect that could really spice up your video, and it does something that normal video can't do. It reveals something that you can't see with a naked eye. For example, time passing. So that's why hyperlapses are really cool. Let's talk about how to do one. Now, you can access the hyperlapse mode while the drone's on the ground just by tapping this button here, scrolling down on the very right-hand side to hyperlapse, and then tap the hyperlapse button. You can't actually switch between the different hyperlapse modes while your drone's on the ground. Tip number one is have the drone up in the air and at least 6 feet above the ground for you to be able to switch between the different hyperlapse modes. Tip number two is you can familiarize yourself with the camera settings while the drone's still on the ground, so you save your precious battery life. Tip number three is that these hyperlapse settings are universal, meaning if you switch your hyperlapse settings for the free hyperlapse mode from, let's say, 8K to 4K, then this will affect your circle, coarse lock, and waypoint mode. You do that just by tapping the little three dots up in the top, then go to camera, and here you see your hyperlapse settings. You can see we have a few options, starting with photo type. Now you can turn them off where you get no photos at all. I don't recommend doing that because, well, memory cards are cheap these days and might as well get the photos, because with the photos you have much more control in post. Now, if you're a beginner and you haven't worked with RAW files before, you might want to choose JPEG, because it's a little bit easier to batch process JPEG files, especially if you don't want to pay money for a software like Affinity Photo, Adobe Lightroom, Photoshop, that kind of thing. Then again, if you know what you're doing and you've handled RAW files before and you know how to batch process RAW files, definitely go with RAW. Also, if you don't know how to batch process images to make a time lapse yourself, I put a video down below in the description where I explain the whole process, whether your images come from a camera or a drone, or just from your phone for that matter. Shot frame is kind of cool. If we turn this on, you can see that you get these little borders around your frame, showing you exactly what's gonna be within the frame of your final time lapse. Next one is the format, MP4 or MOV. I guess there are dozens, hundreds of videos on the internet explaining the difference between the two. My rule of thumb is if you're on a Windows machine, use MP4. If you're on a Mac, use MOV or MOV. And you might be asking, why am I choosing a photo format and a video format? So what am I actually gonna get? Well, you're gonna get both. You're gonna get a pre-baked video that the drone is making while it's up in the air, and that's a cool thing and a not so cool thing. And you're also gonna get all the photos. So why do I say it's cool and not so cool? Well, obviously, as the drone records a hyperlapse, it shoots one photo after another. You're choosing the video format because once the drone has recorded the last picture, it will automatically start creating a video. And the cool thing about that is, if you're new to this and you don't really know if you got the angle right or the composition right, or, well, if it looks good at all, then you can review it while the drone is still up in the air and review your 5, 6, 7 second hyperlapse. And if you're not happy with it and your battery allows, then you can just try again without like having to land, go to your computer, upload all the pictures, make the hyperlapse, look at it, and you get the idea. The not so cool thing about this is that you can't turn this off. So if you knew what you were doing and you don't want to review it up in the air, the drone will make this video regardless. And depending on the length of your hyperlapse, this can take up to like a minute, maybe even a little bit longer. In my opinion, that's precious battery life that you're losing, but you can't really do anything about that. Now here's a big one, resolution. 1080p, 4K or 8K. If you don't see these options, then you don't have the latest version of your app or the latest firmware of your drone. So you might as well want to go ahead and update this. It's simple. You just go to the About tab and click check for updates, and it will tell you whether or not you have the latest version. So once you've updated your app and your drone's firmware, you'll see those different resolutions. And I'll make a whole video just going over the differences between 4K and 8K, but here's a rule of thumb. In 8K, the drone can only take a photo every 6 seconds. In 4K, the drone can take a photo every 2 seconds. Now, that is 3 times as many photos. So you can get smoother time lapses with the 4K option. And in that regard, 1080p is no different from 4K. It also takes photos every 2 seconds, but the resolution is not as high. So there's that. So probably you just want to stick to 4K. And anti-flicker, you just leave the way it is. If there's a reason why we should be tinkering with this, let me know in the comments down below. Always happy to learn new stuff, but I'll just leave it on auto. All right, let's take a look at all the different hyperlapse options that you have. Once you've set your camera settings, you want to tap the shooting options button, go down to hyperlapse, and here you have your different options. So I'll make a video about each individual one of them, where I show plenty of examples and where you can see what they're good for, what they're not so good for, and what different settings there are. But today I just want to give you an overview of what the different options are and what they do. So let's start off with the free mode. So in the free mode, the drone takes pictures based on the settings you specify down here at the bottom of your screen, but you can still freely control the drone. You can achieve some really cool results with that, but I think it's one of the harder modes because you really have to think about what you want to do, because with all hyperlapses or time lapses for that matter, like, you want to introduce as little change in movement as possible. Obviously it's a hyperlapse, so it means the camera moves, but you don't want to record 17 frames to the right, 23 frames to the left, and then 24 frames to the front. It will just look very jittery. So a good example would be if you wanted to follow a boat in the harbor and you don't know exactly where it's going, but a boat is not going to change directions drastically. So you can slowly and smoothly follow the boat while making sure you keep it in frame during your hyperlapse. Or another really good example for the free mode is if you actually don't want the drone to move at all and you just want to get it to a certain altitude, you leave it there and then you take a time lapse, basically a still time lapse of the sunset, for example. Make sure that it's not a windy day, because your hyperlapse is going to turn out pretty jittery, like you can see here in this hyperlapse that I recorded just the other night. So the next one is circle, and it's exactly what you would expect. It flies a circle around a subject that you have to specify first. So you do that just like with any of the quick shot modes. If you don't know the quick shots at all, I have a whole video series about them. They're down below in the description. So what you want to do is you want to draw a rectangle around your subject and then specify the direction and the speed, and you want to click start, so the drone will fly a circle around your specified subject. So the cool thing about this is it will track the subject while it's taking the pictures and it's doing the hyperlapse. I think the best example for this would be like a busy traffic island where the drone circles around and you have lots of cars moving in and out. So this is what you could do with a circle hyperlapse. Okay, so the next one on the list is course lock, and it's probably my most used hyperlapse mode for the DJI Mavic Air 2. So first you want to determine the direction and lock the course like so, and once you've done that, you choose your camera settings here at the bottom, just like with all the other modes, and then you hit start. The cool thing with that is now the drone will fly continuously into that direction, but you still have control over the yaw. So in other words, you can still rotate the drone left or right, but it will continuously fly into the direction that you have locked it in. So you can still go up and down, but again, like, you want to introduce as little extra camera movement as possible, because it will make it more jittery. So Chorus Lock is definitely the easiest mode to start with. It's easy to master, you can still get fantastic results, and you don't have to think too much about it. You just set a direction, you point it at something that's moving and that's interesting, and you let it go. Okay, and the last one is the waypoint mode, which can be really cool, but it's also pretty involved because you have to think a lot about what your waypoints should be and what the results are that you're trying to achieve with it. Okay, so you set up your waypoints just by flying to each individual one of them, like wherever you want the drone to go, and once you're at that location, you just add it to your waypoint list. Now, it is quite inefficient because obviously you have to waste precious battery life by flying to each individual point, and when you start the waypoint hyperlapse, the drone will first fly back to the original starting waypoint, which loses more battery, then it will fly down the waypoints to do the hyperlapse, and then will fly back to the original waypoint where you kicked it off. You're losing battery life three different times here. You can counter that a little bit by flying it in reverse. After you've set up your last waypoint, you can choose the reverse option here, so the drone doesn't have to fly all the way back to the first waypoint. It will basically just fly down all the waypoints in reverse order, that way conserving a little bit of battery life. All right, and that's it for today. Those are all the hyperlapse options we have. I hope you learned something. I hope you're making your own cool hyperlapse creations with what you've learned here today. Thanks so much for watching. There are videos down below in the description about every single one of them with more examples and use cases. So if you're interested in seeing more about any individual one of those modes, check the description down below. If they are not in the description just yet, you will have to wait until next week. So make sure you click the little red button down below to subscribe to the channel and the bell icon right next to it so that you'll get notified when the next video is coming out. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for support for the channel, and I will see you in next week's video.